Hi, beautiful and blessed. Hello, beautiful and blessed subscribers. How are you doing? Thank you so much for joining me today. We are giving thanks. We are giving praise unto the Almighty God, who is Jesus Christ, our Lord. Yes, guys, so as you have seen in the pic, this is none other than, you know, my absolute favorite Caribbean star. Where else? You know, where else? I know it seems like you've been getting the same meal over and over. Guys, it's my favorite, you know? It's just my favorite. I love it. Like I said, the rice and peas is not my absolute go-to, but I do love it nonetheless. Hence, we're going to be doing it for one last time. Rice and peas for now. All right? And then we're going to give rice and peas a little break. Yes, guys. So, you know, we just want to tell God thanks for another day. We are here, guys. We're here. You know, we could have been elsewhere. We could have been, you know, where. But, you know, we're giving God thanks that He has allowed us the opportunity to be here still in the land of the living. So I hope you guys are stressing. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, Lord. Can never say enough thank you. You know what I mean? So big up again, guys. Thanks again for joining me. I hope you're subscribing. You know, I've been asking you these days to subscribe. I hope you are doing so in order for support and to show your love. Anyway, we're going to get into this and be able to say grace and dive right in. I do have some water on the side, guys. So we're going to say grace. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we want to thank you for the food that you've provided us with. And we do ask that you bless this food. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen and amen. Yes, guys, so this is nothing new. I actually almost ate with the bag underneath this. Why? Because the gravy was drenched. When I said drenched, the gravy was totally drenched in the bag. So I almost had was to have the bag underneath here, but I decided, you know what? It's gonna be drenched underneath, but nobody really looks to see that part, so you know. But I'm just letting you know. Alright? So that's how much gravy is put in the containers. And it happened to be spilled over, you know, when delivery and all of that. Spill over. Have some vegetable here. You know, I prefer to have my avocado, guys. Have any ready avocado right now, so I have to set it for what it comes with. After looking for the fat, I don't want to eat too much fat. Talk about fat. Fat up here. Yes, guys, so how are you guys doing? A nice juicy salad. Normally, I'll lift up the plate to show you how the meal looks, but it's so drenched, guys. be looking out for the fat, because a lot of fat. Not too much, but just enough where I can see, spot them. Tomatoes, very juicy. When you hear me saying so good, I don't want it to take me lightly, you know, guys, because I don't think I say so good for every meal that I eat, but this one happens to be. When you get like your fingers, then you know how good it is. One vegetable I could see myself eating with this is people might notice it as what do we call it? Coleslaw. But in other words, it would have been like a vegetable carrot with, I think, cabbage or shredded cabbage, and they do it to make it sweet. I think it's just I don't know what they call it though. All I know, I love that type of salad. If it's not avocado, that would be the salad I like. I'll enjoy it with this meal. I would say that it's not necessary for this meal, though, because the oxtail is very sweet. However, the chef prepared it, it's very sweet. Oh, it is good. Very sweet, so it's like if you were to have the vegetable that I'm telling you about sweet and the meal sweet, it would have been too much, you know. So I guess they make this bland so that way it can balance it out. Like I said, guys, you know, just a simple avocado for me would have done the trick. I felt like I bite into a pimento, so I have to make sure. One of the worst feelings when you bite into a pimento and you want to bite and see? Just like what I said. There goes the pimento seed. I knew I felt it, man. But when I start enjoying it and start biting the minute and realize there's a pimento, I think I would have just closed up the meal right away after that. It's just too much. take that back. It's not a lot of fat. Not too soon, but it's not a lot of fat compared to last video probably I had. By the one prior. So good. Be honest, guys, I ain't gonna lie. The best part of eating the oxtail from Karen's shop is just knowing you have the thickness of the gravy with rice. And when you get to, when all of the juices, you know, just kind of settle into the bone, and then you know that's when you just, that's my enjoyment. I don't know about you. That's where I get my enjoyment from. Mm-hmm. Well, guys, as you can tell from that long drink, that's a wrap for me. That's it for me, guys. I am totally done. But that oxtail was good. I'm full. There's some more meat. I don't think a lot of meat was in this one. A lot of veggie, finally the veggie actually remains veggie looking, if you know what I'm saying, because sometimes the way how it's drenched with gravy, you can't really tell where the vegetable would be because it's so buried under the gravy, but now it's visible, which is a plus. As I said, it's not a lot of meat there right now left back when I want to do like a eating. I see a lot of fat on this. Go ahead and take it off, so when I'm ready to have it, I know that there's no fat left on it, so I can just go ahead and dive in when I'm ready. But yes, guys, this is it. If you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? If you haven't given me a like yet, what are you waiting for? If you haven't given me a comment yet, I know the ones who usually comment, you know, and I appreciate you guys. But I'd like to hear from the newcomers, ones that, you know, just came on board. And, you know, I want to hear what you guys have to say. Welcome again to the channel. It's all about the oxtail from Caramel Star. It's not too garlicky. I'm almost sure they cook with garlic. Almost everybody, I would think, that has a restaurant with some level of garlic, but that's the thing. I don't mind to eat garlic, but I just don't think I have to lift it up out of my meal like this and visibly see it in an oxtail. I think that it's how you seasoned it, whether you want to. A lot of people grind their seasoning, whether it be the thyme or the scallion or the garlic or the ginger. A lot of people can grind it, a lot of people just rub it up and let it sit with it and cook with it. A lot of people, you know, chop it up in mince pieces. You know, we do a lot of different ways of how we cook stuff, but end of the day, for me, when I'm buying a meal or when I'm eating a meal, whether I'm making or not, I just love to know that even if it's in it, like onion, if I were to start really preparing meals, grind stuff because I love cooking with onion because it gives it a nice flavor, but I don't want to eat it like raw, like cooked, whether cooked or raw. I don't want to eat it like that. I'd rather grind it. So I think maybe this right here, I have a lot of powder seasoning, whatever. So I'm tasting a particular sauce, an oxtail sauce that I used to cook with that I didn't like, but for some reason, I think I liked how they prepared it with that sauce. I believe it's an oxtail sauce that you can get, but it's nothing like putting flavors together and making it be as good as what this is. So I'm not gonna pick apart what I think they made it with, but all I know, I have some ideas. Bottom line, guys, it's good enough to go out and get it. As I said, there's other restaurants elsewhere, but you don't want to go somewhere and then you'd be like, boy, Jano, you know, I'm gonna spend this amount of money or that amount of money, and you know, the meal never tastes good. You don't want that, you know what I'm saying, guys? So you want at the end of the day to get something that you're satisfied with all the time, or I would say majority of the time, because I haven't had any complaints. The most complaint I will have every now and again is too much rice or no butter. Actually, I didn't even talk about butter bean, because right now I think I'm so over it. I have to go get in touch with them and find out what's going on with the butter bean. Is it that when I kind of steering away completely from it, or I can't get any butter bean? What's going on? But either way, it still didn't take away from the meal. The meal was good regardless of not having butter bean. It's just when you're raised a certain way with eating it with butter bean, you're always kind of looking for some is even one or two, or maybe three or four butter beans. But it was good regardless. You know, as I said, I'm not a tossed salad girl. I'm an avocado girl. In other words, like I see in the comments about pear. Yes, guys. Yes, we call avocado pear in Jamaica. Don't know which other part of the country or world people twist the words of it, and so, and I don't know where it came from. I don't know who started that, but we in Jamaica, we call avocado pear. I don't even know what they call pear, now that I'm familiar with the actual pear itself. But anyway, I guess I'd have to ask a Jamaican when I woke up one in the streets, or you know, because I'm not really a pear lover. I never grew up eating pear, so the actual pear, not avocado pear. But so I don't know. I've never grew up eating it. I think I probably tried it once, but you know, when you're not used to something, you don't really maybe you could try it again, but I would try it again in a juicing, because I love to juice stuff. And don't forget, guys, you'll be seeing a lot more video. You might see a lot of me making juice these days instead of actually just eating. You might see some of that in more recent times to come, because it's a hot day and you want something refreshing. You want to have your ice cubes pop in, and you want to have your juice ready so that way you can be nice and healthy and all of that. You want to mix it up, guys. You know, a lot of unhealthy stuff, yeah, but you want to make sure you have some healthy stuff on the other side. Okay, guys, so don't forget to, you know, like, share, subscribe, and comment, guys. Comment, support the channel. Support you ladies. It's the Truthy, aka Truth. Support me. Show me love. Anyway, this is where I'm leaving you guys. Don't forget to stay prayed up, guys. Stay prayed up. Stay in the presence and in the realm of God, because right now, times are perilous. Everything is in haywire, but guess what? God still remains on the throne. He was there then, he's here now, and he'll be there forever. So guys, when you think that, you know, I wonder where God is. God is still on the throne, guys. So remember, you can call upon him, whether you're weak or so. Anyway, it's coming on 20 minutes. I'm not about to go over that. Guys, thank you again so much for joining me. Signing off. Good night. Or good day. Wherever part of the country you're from, keep watching and stay tuned. Don't forget to watch all the videos back to back. Bye, guys.